So last night I was part of the release here on Malau. A little bit of an emotional moment seeing bush stone curlews reintroduced back on Phillip Island.
What we're going to learn from this reintroduction on Phillip Island is how we can coexist with threatened species. Phillip Island is fox-free, so we have a real opportunity to make a difference to threatened species within Victoria.
Odin Arta Foundation works with species that are really at critical levels, so critically endangered and endangered. It's a really special place, and you kind of get to see what it would have been like pre-European settlement, which is pretty cool. The curlews, we've been breeding these animals for over 10 years in captivity. We have got them all genotyped. We pair and breed accordingly to that information that we get. Then we can translocate the best genetically fit animals to these sites.
I'm working on a recipe of how to better translocate bush stone curlews. There's been a lot of attempts in the past with mixed success, and so we wanted to know what are the tactics and strategies that help them survive best post-release. The benefit of using GPS trackers is you can get thousands of fixes and get a really fine scale look at what the birds are doing, both in terms of their habitat use and their social interactions. The way we fit the GPSs is I hand sew teeny tiny backpacks to put on the birds. We make the backpacks in such a way that they're very comfortable on the bird, and the devices themselves only weigh 20 grams.
So my PhD is very much working on Shoshana's recipe for translocation for bush stone curlews into southeastern Australia. The major point of difference here is instead of having a fenced sanctuary for the curlews to go into, we have an island sanctuary and everything that comes with it, including the people, the cars, the pets. And so really building on that recipe to maximise success for our bush stone curlews in southeastern Australia.
The community is really important to the work we do here at Phillip Island Nature Parks. All of the work that we do affects the community, and we want to involve them, hear from them, to let them know about our threatened species plan and raising awareness about the bush stone curlew reintroduction.
The vision for introducing bush stone curlews is to try and build the population so it becomes sustainable and get them off that critically endangered list. So into the future, we're able to reintroduce bush stone curlews in other areas that are safe for them to do so. We've had great success with our past threatened species programs like the Eastern Barred Bandicoot, and moved that status from critically endangered to endangered. Our vision is to continue that success for our threatened species programs.
We started our trial release of bush stone curlews. This is actually done in a staged approach, releasing a small number of birds each time, and we're monitoring them very closely. We're doing this together with our partners, the Odin Arta Foundation, the Australian National University, and the Penguin Foundation has made this all possible.
Right now we have maybe 50 to 100 wild bush stone curlews in Victoria. And this program could up to double, even triple, the number of bush stone curlews that we see in Victoria, which is a massive, tangible outcome that we have for this species.